Far too many computer games have claimed to be interactive movies lately, and far too few even come close to living up to the claim. But the technology continues to improve drastically, and Origin's upcoming science fiction adventure BioForge will definitely blow away all other attempts to bring cinematic action to the PC. IE talked to game designer Ken Demarest about this remarkable project.
We wanted to put you as though you were an action adventure hero. Action hero, kind of Arnold Schwarzenegger, Bruce Willis, Die Hard kind of a character, right into the movie. And so, yes, you're seeing a character who's doing fantastic movie-like things and great stunts and, fighting in a very stuntman sort of movie way, but you're also him.
The player takes the part of a cyborg whose name is Lex, although he doesn't even remember that much about himself.
He started out locked in a cell with a guardian robot. And when you awaken, you've been horribly altered. You don't even know who you used to be. Your memory has been wiped. But it becomes very rapidly apparent, because of the earthquakes, that something has gone horribly wrong. You've got to escape from the cell and discover who has done this to you and why. Along the way, you encounter an alien civilization, discover that alien technology has actually been used to create you. And in addition, that you had the opportunity to uncover a sinister plot to take over Galactic Rule.
BioForge follows the example of the Alone in the Dark series by showing the action from numerous shifting camera angles. Special care has to be taken not to disorient the player when the angle changes.
Because you've seen movies before, you have a very regular sense of what's supposed to happen in a movie. When there's a cutaway from one scene to another, you aren't surprised. It's very normal for you. And so there's this whole big list of established rules that movie makers use.
In addition to normal cinematic rules, we've been developing a layer on top of that, which is kind of interactive cinema rules for how the cameras should react, how the music should react, what sound effects should be like, and all that sort of thing.
The keyboard interface is very flexible and takes very little time to get used to.
So by using the keyboard, you can walk, you can run, you can climb things, you can control all of the combat maneuvers, and because we have a generalized use key, when you get in special situations, the character your main character has about 250 moves, just him alone, that he can use during the game. So you can do a lot of specialized things like force open doors, climb up and down ladders, press buttons and turn valves.
All of these actions are performed with incredibly fluid and lifelike motion, thanks to a motion recording hardware system called a flock of birds.
The first time I ever heard of it was back in the 70s, when they were using sensors of some kind on Olympic athletes to analyze the physics of what the Olympic athletes were doing when they were running and jumping, and try to make them more efficient athletes.
What you're looking at here is Star's umbilical cord, which leads down to this huge, huge amount of hardware here called the flock of birds. We use an in-house program that we've developed called Salsa, the system for animating lifelike synthetic actors, to actually read in data in real time from this hardware into the computer. And then we use that information later on in the game so that you can control your character.
So what does all this mean? It means that when you see your cyborg cower in the futuristic environment, it all started with QA leader Star Long cowering here in the Origin Systems cafeteria. The combination of cinematic cutscenes with the interactive portions are flawless, giving even more of a movie-like atmosphere to this remarkable product. BioForge contains adventure-type puzzle-solving, lots of combat action, and an intense musical soundtrack that reacts to your actions. Look for it this winter.